एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज आशिम दत्ता एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट TTL एंड CMOS कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ट्रेनर एंड इट्स ऑर्डर कोड इज 38696। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इट्स वर्किंग। नाउ लेट्स सी द कंपोनेंट्स दैट आर प्रेजेंट ऑन द किट। सो दिस इज द DC सप्लाई एंड दिस इज द पोटेंशियोमीटर पोर्ट। बाय यूजिंग दिस पोर्ट वी कैन वेरी द वैल्यूज। देन दिस इज द पल्स जनरेटर सेक्शन। This is the power on off button. Then this is the TTL NAND gate section. Then this is the TTL NOT gate section. Then this is the CMOS NAND gate section. Then this is the CMOS NOT gate section. Now we are going to perform an experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to study the voltage transfer characteristics, noise margin and gate propagation delay of TTL NAND gate. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the I1 of TTL NAND gate to the 14th pin. Then we will connect the 14th pin of the TTL NAND gate with the VCC plus 5 volt DC supply. Then we will connect the ground to the 7th port of the ground. Then we will connect the VIN, that is the second port. We will connect it to the VO of potentiometer section. Then we will connect the VCC or VDD port to the plus 5 volt DC supply. So that is how the connection is done. So after the connection is done, now we will connect this multimeter. So we will keep it at DC volt and now we will connect it at the VIN port like this, and we will use this potentiometer to increase or decrease the voltage value. So when it is at fully anti-clockwise direction, then the voltage is zero. Now we will give some voltage. So by rotating it in clockwise direction, we can see that the voltage increases. So let's keep this voltage at 1 volt. So now we will read the voltage at the output. So at output, we will connect this voltmeter now at Vout and ground port of the TTL NAND gate, and now we will see that the voltage is 1.6 volt, and at the input the voltage that is provided is 1 volt. Now we will again increase this voltage. We will rotate this potentiometer in clockwise direction. So now let's keep it at 2 volt. So you can see that it is approximately 2 volt. So by rotating this potentiometer in clockwise direction, we can increase the input voltage, and now we will measure the Vout. So for that we will connect this probe to the ground and we will connect this port to the Vout of the TTL NAND gate, and now we can see that the voltage is 0.1 volt. So that is how you can take the readings and you can form this graph that is mentioned in the manual. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now for the gate propagation delay, we have to do some changes in this circuitry. So we will remove this potentiometer connection. Now we have to connect the TTL NAND gate VIN to the pulse generator F output like this, and now we will switch on the DSO and we will take two channels, channel 1 and channel 2. So we will connect the channel 1 at the pulse generator section. So So we will connect this terminal to the F out, and we will connect the ground to the ground of the pulse generator. Now we will take the second channel, then we will connect this second channel to the V out port, and the ground will be connected to the ground. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit to see the waveforms on the DSO. So this is the channel 1 and this is the channel 2. Now we will switch on the kit, and here we can see that this is the channel 1 waveform and this is the channel 2 waveform. We can also measure the delay time. So we have to press at measure, and we will press F5, and we will press F5 for parameters. So here we can see the parameters rise, fall. We can take the readings from here for channel 1, and for channel 2 we have to press F2 so that we get channel 2 readings. So that is how we can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study the voltage transfer characteristics, noise margin and gate propagation delay of TTL NOT gate. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect plus 5 VCC port of the TTL NOT gate to the VCC port of the potentiometer P1, and we will connect this port to the DC power supply plus 5 volt, and we will connect the VO port of potentiometer P1 to the VIN port of the TTL NOT gate. Then we will connect the ground port to the ground port of the DC power supply. So that is how the connection is done. So now after the connection is done, now we will switch on the kit, and we will connect the voltmeter across ground and VO port of the potentiometer P1. So here by rotating this port we can vary the voltage, the input voltage. So let's provide the input voltage 1 volt. So here you can see that the voltage is approx 1 volt. So this is the input voltage. Now we will measure the output voltage. So we will connect this probe to the ground, and we will connect the positive to the V out. So here you can see that at the output voltage we are getting 4.96 volt. Now we will increase the input voltage. So now let's keep it at 2 volt. So here you can see that the input voltage is 2 volt. Now we will measure the output voltage. So at output we are getting 4.22 volt. Similarly you can take the readings and you can form this graph that is mentioned in the manual. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now for the gate propagation delay, we have to make some changes in this connection. So we will remove the connections from potentiometer, and now we will connect this DC supply plus 5 volt to the VCC of the TTL NOT gate like this, and we will connect the ground to the ground, and we will connect this V in port of TTL NOT gate to the F out of pulse generator, and now we will connect the V out of the TTL NOT gate to the V in of this TTL NOT gate. So that is how the connection is done. So after the connection is done, now we will switch on the DSO and we will switch on the kit, and now we will connect the channel 1 of DSO at the pulse generator F output and the ground port like this. And now we will connect the channel 2 of DSO to the V out of TTL NOT gate and the ground port like this. So that is how the connection is done, and you can observe the waveform on the DSO. So this is the channel 1, that is the input, and this is the channel 2, that is the output waveform. And you can measure the delay by using this DSO. So here you can measure the rise time, fall time, duty cycle, peak, average, RMS for channel 1, and for channel 2 you have to press F2, then these are the readings for channel 2. So that is how you can take the readings from here and you can observe the waveform on the DSO. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study the voltage transfer characteristics, noise margin and gate propagation delay of CMOS NAND gate. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the 1-4 pin of CMOS NAND gate to the I3 pin, then we will connect the VCC plus 12 to the VCC of potentiometer, and we will connect the VCC of potentiometer to the plus 12 of DC power supply. Now we will connect the ground to the ground, and we will connect the V input to the VO of potentiometer like this. So that is how the connection is done. So after the connection is done, now we will switch on the kit and we will use this multimeter to read the voltage. So we will keep it at DC volt, and now we will connect the ground to the ground, and we will connect this plus probe to the VO of P1 potentiometer, and now we will give some voltage at the input. So let's give 1 volt at the input. So here you can see that as I have rotated this potentiometer in clockwise direction, I have increased the voltage to 1 volt. Now we will measure the output voltage. So we will connect the ground to the ground, and we will connect the positive to the Vout. So here at Vout we are getting 11.82 volt. Now we will again increase the input voltage. So currently it is 1 volt, and now we will keep it at 2 volt. So the input voltage is approximately 2 volt. Now we will measure the output voltage. So at output we are getting 11.82 volt. So that is how you can take the V input and V output readings, and you can form the graph that is mentioned in the manual. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now for gate propagation delay, we have to make some changes in this circuit. So we have to remove the connections from potentiometer port, and we will connect this V in to the pulse generator F output like this, and we will remove this VDD connection, and we will connect this VCC directly to the VDD plus 12 volt DC supply. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit. So after the connection is done, now we will switch on the kit and we will switch on the DSO. And for gate propagation delay, we have to give plus 5 volt DC supply. So now you can see that this is the channel 1, that is the input waveform, and this is the channel 2, that is the output waveform. And we can measure the duty cycle values and other parameters on the DSO like this. This is for channel 1, and for channel 2, these are the parameters which we get. So that is how you can perform this experiment, and you can observe the waveforms on the DSO like this. Similarly, you can do this for the CMOS SMIT trigger NAND gate. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study transfer characteristics, noise margin and gate propagation delay of CMOS NOT gate. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the VDD, that is the plus 12 volt port of CMOS NOT gate, to the VDD of potentiometer P1, and we will connect it with plus 12 volt DC supply like this. Then we will connect the Vin port to the VO port of potentiometer, and we will connect the ground to the ground port of the DC supply. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit, and now we will connect the voltmeter across the input voltage. So we will connect the voltmeter across the input voltage, and we will rotate this potentiometer, and we will provide some input voltage, let's say 1 volt, and now we will measure the output voltage. So at output we are getting 11.79 volt. Now we will take another reading at 2 volt. You can take readings at different voltage provided at the input, and you can observe the output at the Vout. So I have given 2 volt at the input, and now we will measure the output voltage. So at output we are getting 11.59 volt. So that is how you can take the V input and V output voltage readings, and you can plot the graph that is mentioned in the manual. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now for gate propagation delay, we have to make some changes in the circuit. So firstly we will switch off the kit, and now we will remove the connections from potentiometer port, and now we will connect the Vin port of the CMOS NOT gate. We will connect it to the pulse generator port Fout, and we will connect the VDD of CMOS NOT gate to the plus 5 volt DC supply, and we will connect the Vout to the Vin port. And now we will connect channel 1 of DSO at pulse generator port like this, and we will connect the channel 2 of DSO to the CMOS NOT gate port like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit. So here you can see that this is the waveform which we get. So at channel 1 we are getting the input waveform, and at channel 2 we are getting the output waveform, and you can measure the parameters on the DSO like this. This is the channel 1 parameters, and this is the channel 2 parameters. So that is how you can perform this experiment. And you can also perform the CMOS SMIT trigger NOT gate. The connections are given in the manual, and you can take the observations by doing the connections. So that is how you can perform all the experiments that are mentioned in the manual. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.